It is time for quick Om chanting. Take a comfortable position. Keep your backbone straight. Brahmanad. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Swastha.
Hello students, last class we discussed the general characters of phylum Ctenophora, which is a minor phylum consisting of a few genera. The animals are exclusively marine. The most significant characteristic features of the phylum Ctenophora are the bioluminescence and the presence of lasocells or the coloblasts. What are the significant characteristic features, characters of the phylum Ctenophora? Yes, these are the bioluminescence and the presence of lasocells. Are called the coloblasts, which cells are called excretory organ of Ctenophora. Yes, cell rosettes or rosette cells. Ctenophores are commonly known as gum jellies or sea walnuts, gum jellies or sea walnuts. Because the presence of 8 meridional ciliated dais, Ctenophores are commonly known as gum jellies. Why they are called gum jellies? Because of presence of ciliated gum plates. Development of Ctenophores is indirect. The fertilization is external. They do only sexual reproduction. Fertilization is external. Development is indirect with a pre-swimming larval stage, that is centipede larva. Animals of which class of phylum Ctenophora don't have tentacles? Yes, the class Nuda. Animals of class Nuda, they do not contain, consist of the tentacles. And which class, the animals of which class are having the tentacles? Yes, Tentaculata.
In this session, we are going to discuss phylum Platyhelminthes. The term Platyhelminthes is derived from two Greek words, platy and helminthes. Platy means plant, helminthes means worm. The Platyhelminthes term derived from the Greek word platy means plant and helminthes means worm. So these Platyhelminthes, the animals commonly known as flatworms, commonly known as flatworms. Where do they live? They live in the parasitic form, in the vertebrates, in the body of vertebrates. Mostly are parasitic. Mostly these animals are parasitic. within the body of other organism or on the body. On that basis, they may be endoparasite or ectoparasite.
Mostly these are parasitic form, parasitic in nature. That may be, they may be endoparasite or ectoparasite. And if you are freely
they live independently,
freely. The free living forms
may be marine or freshwater.
Free living forms may live in maybe marine or freshwater. Freshwater animals. These are, as we discussed, the flatworms. These are dorsoventrally flattened. How are they? These are dorsoventrally flattened. Dorsoventrally flattened.
Just you can see they may look like leaf or ribbon line.
They may be maybe leaf like or ribbon like animals. See the liver tube,
planaria,
and the anterior part of tapeworm, the tinea solium is given over here. Tinea solium. The tinea solium are the tapeworms, commonly called tapeworms. The planaria is commonly known as Dugesia, also known as Dugesia. The liver tube, the seed liver tube, forming the liver of the seed. Okay, this is known as fasciola hepatica. Fasciola hepatica. Hepatic is related to liver. Hepatica is related to liver, and the tube, this worm, is found in the liver of the seed. They exhibit the organ level of organism. These animals belong to the organ level of organism. Gland sac, body gland, these are triploblastic. Gland sac, body gland, there is only one mouth. The digestive system is developed, only mouth is there. Mouth is like, you see here also, a branch system, that digestive system is there.
but only a structure mount. Anus is absent. Anus is absent. So these are blind cell body plan. Belong to blind cell body plan. Triploblasty. These are having the ectodol, endodol, and mesodol. Ectodol, mesodol, and endodol. Inner layer is endodol, outer layer is ectodol, middle layer is mesodol. Mesodermal cells are present by filling the body cavity as loose connective tissue called parenchyma. The mesodermal tissue the mesodermal cells are present mesodermal tissue present is in the body cavity fill the body cavity as loose connective tissue loose connective tissue called parenchyma. Tissue called parenchyma. The mesodermal tissue is known as parenchyma. These are the mesodermal tissue. These are called parenchyma tissue or parenchyma. These are acoelomates. These are triploblasty but acoelomates. Animals, these are the first triploblastic animal. These are first bilaterally symmetrical animals. First bilaterally symmetrical animals. Bilaterally symmetrical animals. As we discuss, a single plane divides the animal into two equal halves, having the corresponding structures. The first triploblastic platelets, first organ level of organization, animals with the organ level of organization, the platyhelminthes. The first bilaterally symmetrical animals, platyhelminthes. So note it down, very important. As we discuss the organ level of organization, you see the tibia sola, which is commonly known as tapeworm. This body is having the parts pollex. Pollex means the head. Here the first cephalization. The cephalization begins in these animals. Cephalization. Cephalization means formation of head. Head formation. Cephalization means head formation. Begins here because of the formation of head. You can you see even eyes are here. Eye, mouth is here. The structure, it by seeing this structure we can understand this is the head region. This is the opposite side of the ball of that head region. It's the tail region. So the cephalization, the head structure of head is formed. Cephalization begins in these animals. Cephalization begins In these platforms, in these animals, what are the structures? Yes, pholex is there, worms, pholex is there, neck is there. Then the proglottids. These are not the true segmentation, but proglottids and rest the body is segmented in tapeworms. We will discuss the class. There are three classes: Turbellaria, Trematoda, and Cystoda. What are the three classes? Just it will be better to discuss right now. Three classes. What are they? The Turbellaria, then Trematoda, and Cystoda. The Turbellaria, the animals coming under Turbellaria, the Planaria. These are three living forms. For example, these are the three living forms. The Trematoda may be ecto or endoparasites. Cystoda, these are generally endoparasites. The animals of Turbellaria, for example, the Planaria. The Trematoda, they are commonly known as Phleops. And the Cystoda, they are commonly known as tapeworms. Okay, so the liver tube consider Trematoda, and the tapeworm, the Tinea solium consider Cystoda. These animals are having the sucker, helps in to hold the body up host, helps in to hold the body of host. And the parasitic forms are having the sucker. Here the oral sucker having two rows, double rows of hooks. This structure, a differentiated structure, is called rostella. These are the side suckers, and this portion is called pholex. This is called pholex head. Pholex means head, neck, and the body. Body is divided into segments, which is not the true segment. And these segments are called proglottids. These are called proglottids. And at the anterior region, the immature proglottid. Then the mature proglottid, and these are rapid proglottids. So, what are the organs? The suckers, rostella, hooks, eyes, okay, and mouth is present. The digestive system is present but incomplete without anus. The proglottids consist of, make it a double D, okay, all are proglottids. Each proglottid, the segments are called proglottid.
Each proglottid consists of a set of reproductive organs. These reproductive organs consist of male and female. These animals are hermaphrodite. Animals are hermaphrodite.
If you are the unisexual, the hermaphrodite means these are bisexual or monoecious. Hermaphrodite, also known as bisexual or monoecious. Monoecious. These are the synonyms. Remember. Means male and female sex organs are present in the same organism, same individual organism, and they can produce egg as well as sperm. So here each proglottid segment can consist of a male and female sex organ producing the egg and sperm. This is specifically seen in the tapeworms. Okay. Mostly these are hermaphrodite or monoecious, but Schistosoma, Mansoni, Schistosoma, Haemotobium, these are dioecious. These are dioecious. Dioecious means male and females are separate. The male and female organism are separate. Schistosoma, Mansoni, or Haemotobium. But mostly the hermaphrodite. Asexually they reproduce. Asexually reproduction by fragmentation. Asexual, you can write down asexual reproduction by fragmentation. And sexual reproduction by gamete formation. Sexual reproduction by gamete formation. Gamete, egg and sperm, by gamete. Fragmentation, when a small fragment, you might have studied, if the head or tail or this aplanaria, head part or the region or the tail region or the middle part, any segment can develop into a complete new organism, new planaria. So, the fragmentation, asexual reproduction by fragmentation seen in planaria, common in planaria. Sexual reproduction by gamete means egg and sperm. Fertilization is internal. Fertilization is internal. Development is direct or indirect. In some animals, it is development is direct or indirect, mostly indirect. Through many larval forms, and indirect through many larval forms. these are Miracidium, Sporocyst, Radia, Cercaria, Metacercaria. What are they? Miracidium, Sporocyst, Radia, Cercaria, Metacercaria. The larval forms are the different stages of larval form, different stages of larval forms. These are Miracidium, then Sporocyst, Radia, Cercaria, and Metacercaria. These are the different forms, and Miracidium is the most active form of the larva. Okay? So what are these soccers? Soccers means at the center there is a vacuum space, empty, nothing is there. And on the border there is a ring like structure, cellular structure. Suppose this is the cellular structure. Center vacuum is there, these are the cells. It helps in attachment because of this vacuum, by sucking it remain attached to the surface, the body of the host bhojadata, parasite, porajivi, as you tell in Korea. So this is the sucker, the parasitic form, they remain attached to the body of the host. So, locomotory organs are absent, but the suckers and hooks help in, attachment. The parasites remain attached to the body of host by the suckers. The parasites remain attached to the host body by these structures with the help of suckers and hooks, with the help of these attachments. By the help of these suckers and help on suckers and hooks, the digestive system is branched but without thallus. The digestive system is present over here. There is a mouth. Even though the digestive system is branched, but anus is absent, and the mouth only present. Digestive system is branched and with mouth present with mouth, but anus is absent, so it is incomplete. So it is digestive system is it is incomplete. The respiration is done through the body surface. As the parasitic forms they live in the host body, they do not need any special organism. They do the anaerobic respiration, and even the digestion, they absorb the nutrients through their body surface. The parasitic forms, digestive system is incomplete. Respiration is also done through the body surface. And parasitic forms, parasites, they do anaerobic respiration. Their respiration, they get the energy without oxygen. They do the respiration without oxygen. Excretion. Excretion is done by specialized cells called plain cells. These plain cells are also known as protoneuplia. Nephridia. Proto means primitive time. Nephridia came from the nephron. Nephron, you know, the cell of the kidney. So protonephridia, plain cells are also known as protonephridia. They do not have the special excretory organ or excretory system, but they have the specialized cells called plain cells or protonephridia. They look like this, the plain cells. As the some ciliary structure, plain like ciliary structure, cilia are present. So they are called, these type of cells are called the plain cells. And excretory product is the ammonia. So these are also anaerobic. Excretory product is ammonia. So animals are amphibian. Hence are amygdalic they do osmoregulation and means they balance the ion and water as well as they excrete the excretory product waste product respiration as we discussed the respiration is done through the body surface nervous system here I have shown you the nervous system is primitive type ladder like a ladder third the simple brain like structure that is the ganglia and the double solid nerve with the these are connected these two nerve cords are connected nervous system is ladder like having the brain two longitudinal this is brain like ganglion is here brain two nerve cords and these are the connectives these are the transverse connectives okay so nervous system consists of brain means ganglia nothing else this is the ganglia no true brain cephalization is started the ganglion the brain the two longitudinal nerve cords and the transverse connectives transverse this is longitudinal this is transverse connectives which connects with the connectives here the sensory organs are nothing but the eye spots these are you can see these are eye spots the photosensitive these are not true eyes like us these are eye spots eye spots present on the brain So this is the plaque helmet this these are that are having the digestive system but incomplete without anus mouth is present the respiration is done through body surface digestion is also means done by the body surface means nutrients are absorbed by the body surface through the body surface in the parasitic form parasites the circulatory system is not present the body cavity the space in between the body wall and the gut wall is filled with the loose connective tissue called parenchyma the excretory organs are present like the three cells are the protomyxidia. They do the removal of the ammonia. The excretory substance product is ammonia. They excrete, they remove the waste material, that is ammonia. And they even these plain cells balance the water required for the body and ions. Okay, ions which are required maintains. The nervous system is primitive and ladder-like. You step onto that to go to the upstairs or to a higher place. Ladder-like. And nervous system consists of the brain like the ganglion, like the brain, and the two nerves with the connectives, transverse connectives, and the sense organs are iceberg. Iceberg, they are found on the brain. They are sensitive to light stimuli. These animals are hermaphrodite, and these two, the bloody helmet, they show the great power of regeneration. Why great power of regeneration? Any part, any segment of the body develops into a new organism. So they show fragmentation, that is called fragmentation. Asexually they reproduce by the process of fragmentation. Any fragment or segment, the piece of the body develops into a new organism. And asexually they reproduce. Their fertilization is internal. Development is indirect through, mainly indirect through the different stages of larval forms. Meristem, sporocyst, radia, cercaria, metacercaria. Phylum Platyhelminthes is divided into three classes, Capillaria, Trematoda and Cystoda, on the basis of mode of life, whether they are free living like Planaria or the parasitic form like the liver flukes or the Nemia solium, etc. The unique features are they are the first organ level of organization organisms, the first reproductive organism. The animals first the shown the cephalization. Cephalization, the formation of head is begin. High capacity of regeneration is seen in the planaria. Planaria, these are the Lucasia tigrina, belong to Turbellaria. Okay. So write out the short note with the important points on phylum Platyhelminthes. Even maintain the detailed note for the practice of one more questions. Thank you.